Hey everybody, welcome to Wicked Tarantulas, here with Felicia again today. So, today I have no choice but to take out my 5-inch striped knee tarantula and clean up her exhibit. Something I typically do quite often. I don't like them living in a dirty exhibit. You know, you're supposed to clean their exhibit completely at least once a year. I typically like to consistently keep up on the cleanliness to the walls, to the floor, removing carcasses and all that. Plus, it's my way of making sure that there's no mites or anything else of the sort. I have had that issue one time before, and by all means, I don't want that issue back. I want to keep my tarantulas around and my scorpions as long as I can, give them the longest lifespan as possible. So, for this tarantula, a basic bowl is not going to work. So, we had to get Tupperware. Big holes. She'll fit nice and cozy. We don't want to squeeze her into something too small. I'm not shipping her. If I was shipping her, it'd be a little bit different. You'd want to make sure she was in a tiny cup with very little room to move, that way to protect her abdomen and whatnot. Now, this one has been in pre-molt for quite some time. I call it Goliath. Like I said, it is a striped knee. I have like memory loss some days, like very short term. I don't really know why. So let's get this process started and let's get her into a cleaner exhibit. Okay, so she's kind of sticking out of her hide. You know, this is like an awkward angle, but you can see her. I gotta remove everything because if not, she's gonna run right back in. This is not a tree dwelling species, so I'm not really too concerned about her climbing. As you see, she doesn't do very much of anything. Hey, cool view of the hide. So what we're gonna do, hopefully catch her getting into the container. Oh, she's hip. She is a hardy tarantula. I mean, God, she's so beautiful. She's by God, is she? Oh my God, she's gorgeous. This is my favorite tarantula. I just love the remarkable patterns on her knees. She's been in pre-molt for a long time now. I'm just anticipating this molt already. Like, I'm wishing she would molt. But yeah, she's being stubborn. I'm going to check her hide to make sure there's no mites. Make sure she's okay. I'm just going to gently take care of my baby. So, I guess, let's get on to it. Okay, so one of the first things I'm going to do is remove this water I put in here today. But you see, she has this obsession with being in her bowl, so when she does, everything goes in the bowl. So we're going to take this bowl out. Look at that massive webbing. I feel bad, but I have to make sure that there's no mites in here because, like I said, I have had that issue, and I want to keep my guys and gals around. So one of the first things I'll do is I'll remove the peat moss. I have to break this peat moss apart and actually bury it in the substrate. Lots of like carcasses all over this exhibit. Okay. So what I do is I'll start moving stuff, picking dirt up, observing it close to make sure I don't see anything moving. And if I do, immediately the first thing I do is start cleaning, removing dirt, replacing substrate, so forth. Ow, elbowing up. Glass containers, not pleasant. So I'm going to get to this and I'll get back with you guys when it's time to get her back in. Okay, so this is why I consistently check these exhibits, because mites are carried on their host. And as I started to flip everything around, there's mites. There's one mite right there crawling around. You probably can't see it, but I can. It's right here, right above my finger. See it moving? Yeah, that's definitely not good. So, luckily she's in a new container. If they're on her, I'm not really sure how to get them off, but she's in pre-molt, so I have to change this right away. Just because of the fact is, when she molts and her skeleton's soft, they will bury themselves inside her and they will take her over and they will kill her. So thankfully, I have her out of that. I'm going to open the lid, check it, see if I can somehow get the mites off of her, and I'm going to get rid of this. So, stay with me, guys, and I'll be back to let you know. I'm not 100% sure, but she may have, like, two mites on her head. I don't see them moving, though. So, that might not be mites, but I'm checking her thoroughly, see if any are moving. I don't see any actually on her, but I'm still gonna observe. So with further observation, the mites are coming off of this hide that I purchased from our local pet store. And this is the third hide that I have purchased from a different pet location that has been the cause of mites. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna thoroughly cleanse it. I'm gonna freeze it for 72 hours, bring it back out, scrub it again, maybe thaw it for another 20, freeze it for another 24 hours, thaw it again, and then see where it's at. So right now this girl is not gonna have a hide, and I'm not chancing going and buying another one and doing this again. So just so you guys do know, not only are they carried on the prey that you feed to your tarantulas, but these are a big source of why mites get into your enclosures. So just remember, when you're picking up sticks and things like that off the ground to put into your tarantulas exhibits, just know that you are taking a chance putting pesticides and other things in their enclosure that they should not be. So I'm gonna continue with this, and I'll get back to you and let you know where we're at. We're headed to the pet store. We gotta get some new soil, new mixture, so we can take care of my teas. Let's enjoy some music while we head there. We made it to our destination, guys. Let's get what we need. Baby metallic pink toe for sale. $29.98. Alright, guys, let's get home. Take care of my babies. As I said earlier, we're probably copyrighted. Worth every bit of it. Come on, go! Need to take care of tarantula! Turn! Oh. Charge! On our way home, guys!
The tech is on a break your neck, we ain't no kin. Dreams and hopes to be broken when that flow spin. I'm up for show sin. Level headed when the rebel get it. Heavy metal, that is when I go in.
Let's get in this house and take care of these teas. Alright, so I got this completely cleaned out. Just cleaning up the water now. And then I'm going to add new substrate. She's not going to have a hide, but I'm okay with her not having a hide. She doesn't use it anyways, because usually when tarantulas hit 4 to 5 years of age, they typically stay out of their hide, in which she does. She doesn't really use her hide whatsoever, but when I started moving her home, she decided to go hide because it would probably be a lot easier for her to hide than try to get away. So let me finish drying this up and get substrate in. See you soon. Okay, so this species is supposed to be a burrowing species, although she'd never burrowed. So I added even more substrate this time, and I'm going to pack it down real nice and tight. That way, if she decides to burrow, it'll be firmly packed, and she'll just have to web it up really, really good. She's got more than enough to do what she's going to do, but I know she's not going to burrow. She never does. I'm going to have to add peat moss at a later time. I have to wait for it to do its thing before I can add it. Then I can capture her again and mix it all up again. And then I can inspect to make sure there's no mites again. See, originally this was just supposed to be a cleanup, removing the carcasses and whatnot, and putting her back in to originally how it was. No, I had to change everything. This poor girl. It's not a happy camper, but she's not really mad either, so she's just being mutual. She's in a happy medium. Okay, now I know I've made a video about this tarantula and her need to use the cord to climb to try to escape, but I have no choice but to do a makeshift hide so she has somewhere to go if she feels she needs to hide. So this is only a temporary measure until her hide is available for her again, if I even put it back in. Because like I said, every single time I seem to use core bark, I get freaking mites. Very unsettling and very annoying. So, it's time to get her in. Let's get her in there. Whoop, there goes the camera. And again. Alright, so we're going to get her in. She'll be easy to get in. I could probably just use my hands to pick her up. I ain't gonna do that to the girl. And she's in. No, I did not drop her in. Would never do this to this girl. Such a good girl. Off camera, I was using my brush to attempt to check her for mites. She's not happy, but I'm just making sure. See, she just runs. She's not trying to threaten me or nothing right now. She just backs up. Come on, girl. Mommy's just checking you, baby. Make sure you have no mites, honey. I know you're stressed out. New type of bedding. But I noticed these like little white dots right here, so I used the brush and she let me clean her head off. They were not moving, so I just think it was like pieces of the bedding itself. I don't see anything on her abdomen, but I just noticed her abdomen turning colors right here. So she may be getting closer molting. Or yet again, more hopeful wishing from me. I know, Mama. I'll leave you alone. I just wanted to make sure. I'm going to keep picking and prodding at you for a few days to make sure you don't have any. So, just remember, it is very, very important to check your substrate. It's very important to turn your substrate every now and then, because just because they're not on the top does not mean they're not underneath. And remember, check your core bark. If you want to just eliminate any possibilities, you can bring it home after purchasing it, scrub it, as good as you can, freeze it for 24 hours. I do 72 just to ensure Like I said, I do a thaw up here, then another 24-hour freeze. I don't know what it is about core bark. I just don't know. It's frustrating. All right, thank you guys very much for watching my video today. I hope you guys have a great day. Remember to hit that like button, comment, share, and subscribe. And let me know what you think. I'm good with opinions. I like opinions. Throw them at me. Y'all have a great day. See you on the next one. Bye-bye.